So you've decided that you want to go into a Bachelor of Science degree at DigiPen, but we've got a lot of different ones, and so there could be some question about which one you really want to go into. But the first thing to realize is that for any Bachelor of Science degree at DigiPen, there's a lot of commonality between them. They're all focused on technology, and so there's a common core that goes through all of them. The core starts with computer science. You're going to learn C and C++ in any of these degrees. You're going to learn data structures. You're going to learn algorithms. You're going to become a computer scientist no matter which of these degrees you take. Even ones like the computer engineering that don't have that in the name, or BSCS, these are still computer science. You learn how to code. You also, of course, get a lot of mathematics, because to be a really skilled computer scientist, you have to have mathematics at a level that a lot of other areas do not require. You're gonna have to learn linear algebra, you're gonna have to learn calculus, you're gonna have to learn a lot deeper mathematics than sometimes people expect for this, because to be a skilled programmer, someone who can implement complicated algorithms, you must have that mathematical background. You're also gonna need science, in particular, physics. This is because a lot of what we're doing, whether it's in games, whether it's building computer hardware, or whether it's actually dealing with audio, you must have a real background in physics in order to program this stuff well. And of course, there's also common to all the degrees is general education. So the skills from English to communications to social sciences and humanities, you're gonna have to have some of those as well just to be a well-rounded employee and well-rounded individual once you go out into the professional working world. In addition to the Common Core, if you take the Bachelor of Science in Computer Science, you're actually going to get a lot of training in traditional computer science. Because as you go deeper into it, you'll be able to focus on traditional computer science topics. Things like databases, networking, parallel programming, compilers, and encryption. So this is the traditional computer science topics, but with a DigiPen spin on them. It's still going to be quite difficult, but you're not going to focus as much on the real-time simulation as, say, the RTIS program does. But that doesn't mean that if you want to go into the Bachelor of Science in Computer Science that you aren't going to be able to work on games. You're still going to be able to build the technology, the tools, the infrastructure, the databases that a lot of modern multiplayer games need. Massively multiplayer games, big online games, these are the things that actually need a lot of traditional computer science knowledge behind them to build the giant systems that support them. But of course, you could also go into areas that aren't games, because if you want to go to some of the large companies that actually build all the software that people around the world use today, these are exactly the skills they're looking for and be very interested in hiring you.